Going live, yeah. Hello, hello, hello. Welcome everyone to this live stream, which is very special. We're going to do something very, very exciting, and joining me for it is the one and only Rucha Pujari. Hello, Rucha.
Hello, hello, welcome, Chad.
This
Good
is
to
the
see you.
information you've been looking for your research, right? Wait a second.
Hello, hello, Chad. And I'm so happy to be here today on Chess Plays India stream. It's good to be here and welcome everybody to this fantastic stream that we have planned today. And we are going to be looking at some beautiful chess puzzles and also we'll be trying to solve with the chat.
Okay, beautiful. How are you doing, Rucha? We have met each other in several tournaments, played with you. In fact, guys, Rucha has even beaten me. She's very strong. She's a WIM. And now she's a very, very well-known streamer. In fact, Rucha, you are the first Indian to be verified as a streamer on Twitch. Isn't that true?
Yes, thank you so much. Yes, I'm a Women International Master, and I do remember playing you, but it was so long back, you know. Like playing on the board now feels like another life
Exactly,
completely.
yeah.
But yes, streaming. I started streaming last year on Twitch, and I have been even now I'm on Twitch right now, so it's been great. And I think I am the second Indian streamer to be verified on Twitch. I think first is Vidit, but then he shifted to
No,
YouTube.
Vidit is no longer a Twitch streamer now.
Yeah,
Vidit streams exclusively on YouTube. But also, it's very nice to see you streaming. In fact, guys, Rucha yesterday streamed for as long as 6 hours, just solving positions, and she is very, very doing some creative stuff on Twitch. So I've put a link in the description. So all those who are over here, throughout the day, we'll be looking at all of you joining in over there. So she has around 5,500 subscribers, followers on Twitch,
Hello,
and
yeah.
would love that to reach at least 6,000 today. So we'll try to do that,
Go, go,
Rucha.
go, 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 go.
So
But I'm so happy that we made this collaboration today. I was looking forward to it for some time, and once again, thank you for agreeing to do this.
yeah, my pleasure. And Rucha, we are not alone today. Joining us are two amazing personalities here who are going to be on the solving seat today. Anirban Das Gupta, Vaibhav Setia. Hello, guys.
Hi,
Hello, hello.
hi.
Good to see you, Anirban
Hi,
and
good
Vaibhav.
to see you, Rucha.
Yes.
So just a small introduction. Anirban, Vaibhav, Rucha is a woman international master. She also has two WGM noms and she's very strong. She's from Kolhapur, Maharashtra, and one of the strongest women players, in Maharashtra and India. And she's a very, very well-known streamer now. She streams on Twitch. And so we were planning to do this collaboration with her, like what to do together. And she came up with this idea that we'll have some beautiful chess positions, 20 of them, and which the chat has to solve. And I was thinking that when she sent me the database of 20 positions, they were so nice, so pretty, that I thought, like, you guys have to be here and try to solve it. It's going to be great fun.
Oh, can't wait for it. Great,
Yes,
great.
yes. So this is a great idea. And also, when I sent this to Sagar, he said that, well, I think my students will accept this challenge and do this on the screen. So let's do this.
Yeah, and Rucha, just to tell you about Anirban and Vaibhav, and also Biswa will join in shortly. They are India's topmost stand-up comedians, very, very popular. But they are in love with chess and they practice chess a lot, and they have improved hugely in last 1 year. I think अगर एक साल पहले ये पोजीशन रहता रहा तो मैं बोलता था दिस इज नॉट पॉसिबल, बट नाउ आई फील लाइक दिस इज गोइंग टू बी फन टू सॉल्व.
Yes. I'm of course following all the streams, not only on Chess Base India, but also all the chess streams. And of course, I know all of you, and not only from chess stream, but also before that as stand-up comedians. So I definitely know you all.
Very nice. It's written on your wall, Rucha, keep calm and play chess.
Yes, that is a very important sign, you know.
Yeah, looks good. And also so many trophies behind you.
Yes.
One, I think you've been also the national champion, yes, before you won National B?
Yeah, national challenges I have won, and I have won 6 times nationals of India. So also junior championship, women championship, and also Asian championship. And I have 5 Commonwealth medals. Wow. So I have been playing since I was 6 years old. So it's been a longer journey.
Yeah, so that's why she's really good. I have to set
I have participation certificates in this contest.
Yeah, I have won 2 chess tournaments.
Oh, Anirban, but you won recently, right?
Yeah.
No, not when you were 6.
No.
1 second, let me have Anirban and Vaibhav on the screen here. Soon we'll have Biswa also joining in, but before that, you know, we'll begin. And guys, so not to waste time, the first position is already on your screen. And Rucha, could you tell them what they have to do?
Okay, so today we have a selection of 20 some amazing positions, and it's a mixture of both middle games and end games. So we have already first position on the board, and this is a black to play. So I don't know if you want to flip the board or not. So this is a black to play.
Let me flip it.
And so the pawn is 1 square away from promotion. So the pawn is going to h8, and the position is black to play and draw.
Vaibhav, aap itna serious kyun ho?
Just trying to figure out. No, I was actually thinking, Rucha, is it possible that you can reduce your input volume, the mic volume? I think like yours is high, and then when I reduce my volume, I feel like I can't hear Sagar enough.
Okay.
Just a little. Like.
Cool. Maybe how about now?
Yeah, it's much better.
Okay. So Sagar, how is the point system going to work today?
So the points are going to be the one who gives the right answer will get a 1 point for this. And if Rucha thinks that your answer was decent enough, but not very accurate, you'll get 0.5 point.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll try to, and if it's completely off the mark, then 0.
Okay.
So I have seen
your training stream before. So what do you generally like to study? Like end games or middle games or openings?
You mean all of them? Yeah.
I am too very bad at end games because my games don't reach the end game only, so I don't have practice.
Yeah, but I think today the main aim is to make yourself stretch a bit, and also chat. You will have to think over here what to do as black, because white's idea is very simple. You know, he just wants to come out and queen the pawn.
Yes.
King, okay, should we say or
you will have to just, once you say it, Vaibhav, that will be your answer. Yeah, so just be careful. Yeah. Before you decide on your move.
So then I'll say when we are both ready to say.
Okay, cool.
I have my answer.
Also in the chat, people are writing King F7 / King F8. Guys, this is the entire
That's what you have to think about, right?
Exactly. Do you play your king to F7 or do you play it to King F8?
These are the 2 candidate moves possible. Any other move is just instantly losing on the spot. So if you play king anywhere else, the king comes out to G7 or G8 and white promotes. So it's either King F7 or King F8, but only one is correct.
You know, Rucha, in the chat, people are very, very smart. They are saying knight cannot lose a tempo. And this is something which is very difficult concept. In fact, we had been discussing this with Vaibhav and Anirban. हेलो हेलो गाइस, कैन यू हियर मी?
Yes,
यस
so I thought it was frozen for a moment.
ओके, समथिंग वेंट रॉन्ग या फ्रॉम माई एंड ओनली, बट इट्स नाउ ओके. वी आर बैक, राइट?
Yes.
ओके, कूल. ओके, लेट्स गो. शैल वी? आई विल ऑल्सो, वील हैव अ टाइम लिमिट फॉर ईच प्रॉब्लम, अराउंड रफली अराउंड 3 मिनट्स और सो. सो अनिर्बान, डू यू वॉन्ट टू गो फर्स्ट?
Yes, King F8.
Okay, King F8. And Vaibhav, what about you?
King F7.
King F7 or King F8? Okay, so one of them has to be right.
Yes.
And do you know what is the logic behind any of these moves? Why we should play F8 or F7?
So that when the knight comes to c7, then it can come to e6 or e8, and at that, I think the king will then shuffle between f8 and f7.
Yes. So that's right. The king has to shuffle between F7 and F8, but only one is right. And the correct answer here is King F7. So King F7 is the right solution here. And now let's see what's the difference between these two moves. So
But
let's see why King F8 is not correct.
Vaibhav, you know this already, or you made a guess, or you calculated it? How did
I
it?
calculate.
You
So
calculated.
I mean, I thought that if I just moved my king to f8 once, and then I thought knight c7,
Okay.
and now if I go back up, sorry, not knight c7, knight b6 instead. Yeah, knight b6. And if I go f7 now, which is forced, then knight d7 just
D7, yes,
finishes the
and
king.
now it controls F8 square
Yeah,
and
and
we
if I go to
king.
f7, then the order is like kind of working in my favor.
Yes, so it's the idea is that you have to play the king on the same color square as the knight is. And the idea once again is that the knight piece cannot lose a tempo in the chessboard at all. So you can make waiting moves with any other pieces, but knight every move has to shuffle between light square and dark square. And now even if the knight moves throughout the whole board, you can never lose the tempo. So king f8, knight d7, king f7, and now knight is the one who has to move. And knight moves anywhere, and once again king f8. And that's how black achieves draw here.
The king cannot come out itself, so the pawn cannot queen. So here the first point goes to Vaibhav. Good start here,
Yes,
but
well done.
I think even chat gets half a point, you
चैट ने किंग एफ सेवन स्लैश किंग एफ एट बोला.
know. Yeah, it's like true or false, true slash false.
Yeah, so Rucha, which is the next one?
Okay, so next one is the following one after that.
21st.
Yes.
Ooh, that one is tricky. That one
Yes,
is.
that one is
But I
tricky.
think this is something which you guys will enjoy. What do we have to do here?
Okay, so this in this white has definitely a lot of material advantage, but this one is white to play and mate in three moves.
Ooh, white to play and mate in three. That's the thing. If
Yes.
it was like win in, say, 10 moves, 15 moves, you can win easily. You can move your
Yes,
rook
you can
and
play anything, right?
anything and
Okay,
win.
not anything, because then it can be a stalemate. If
True.
you play king capture g2, it's a stalemate right now.
Yeah.
So
Yeah, I
you need
think
to give a move to black to be able to avoid stalemate, first of
I
all.
to avoid stalemate.
Yeah, there
Oh.
are stalemate concepts in on the board. So if here you just make a move with the queen, for example, this is a stalemate. Nothing
Yes.
moves. This, everything is blocked. So you have to be careful, but also you have to think of mate in 3 moves, and you have 3 minutes, guys. So try to focus. Ki kaise? How will you manage to do? And
Yeah,
look,
I think I solved it.
you solved
By
it.
the way, wow, you solved it! You solved
I
it!
think
This is
so.
amazing. This is
Amazing.
amazing because this is not so easy that you can solve very quickly. By the way, can Vaibhav and Anirban take help from the chat? Is that okay?
No, they won't. I don't think they are looking
Okay,
at the
I
chat.
also, I think, got it.
You guys are
Wow.
not looking at the chat, right, Vaibhav, Anirvan?
No,
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 Yeah.
no.
Okay.
So we both solved. Should we go?
So both of them solved it, Sagar.
Okay, I'm very, very surprised. But let's start with Vaibhav. Yes, Vaibhav.
I thought when you said, let's give them 3 minutes, I thought it's not enough. But they are ready just in 1 minute.
I think Rook G3. Then E3 is forced.
Mm-hmm.
Then Queen G7. Okay. And Bishop takes on G3 and then Queen B7 is made.
Whoa, yeah,
but
look at this.
It's not forced to take the rook there.
No, I mean, even if it's not forced, like, I mean, any other move.
The black can play here, Bishop C7. That's the problem.
This was his idea. This was Vaibhav's idea. And Rucha is saying Bishop C7 here. Ooh,
yes.
And you have to mate on the next move, Vaibhav.
Oh,
and then, yeah, I got it.
Areya.
When is not it?
Okay, and let's go to Anirban. Anirban, what's your answer?
Okay, let's try.
Okay, I was thinking queen, rook c3.
Okay,
rook c3. e3 is the only move for black.
Yes, and then queen to the 7th rank.
And now I'm going to be very tricky and I'm going to just give you a check, bishop h2 check, and your 3 moves are over.
Oh man, okay, thank you. Thank you very much.
I think it's rook g3, queen h7 just solved it.
But the same thing, no? Bishop c7.
Same thing. Bishop h2 and...
For example, e3, queen h7, bishop c7.
Yeah, and then rook g8.
No, mate, nahi hai na, ye fourth move ho gaya abhi. Now it's...
Oh,
now it's made in three, so...
Okay, one more attempt.
Think. You have only now 1.5 minutes. So please think and then respond.
Okay.
Rucha is very tricky. Yeah? She's collected some very,
very
tricky
nice,
positions.
Very nice.
Yes, definitely.
In the chat, people are also trying their best. Guys, try to focus. See, this position, which has been selected, is also a test of trying to find opponent's resources. So if you don't think about opponent's moves, you will always think, oh, I've got it. But if you look at where are his defensive possibilities, Vaibhav, if you found it, please look if there are any defensive ideas for black.
You're right. So, you know, for example, in this case, when you move the queen, you have to count bishop h2 check as an additional move.
True.
And also include that if you're finding mate in three.
Okay, I think I don't know. Thoda confidence.
ek open. You have to open the account, Anirban.
I think I got it. Okay, so...
Wait. I have a little...
Okay, fine.
Also in the chat, very difficult, yeah? Like, people are not finding it easy. Yes, Pranjal Kumar, you are right. Pranjal Kumar is correct. Who else?
Yes, good job.
Hey,
nahi,
I think
nahi, nahi, or I want to dhyan se karo, because every time the sneaky bishop he comes in between your plans.
Yes. And you know, even after you take the bishop, one additional move is g1 and queen with a check.
True.
The funny thing is, Sagar also knows the mistake I made. That now bishop comes in between again.
Every time you move the rook somewhere, the bishop is coming in between in a weird way and stopping you. And mate in 4 is possible, but mate in 3, you have to do it.
Mm-hmm.
By the way, Rucha, where did you get these interesting positions from?
So these collections are from my files, which I have collected over years, and also some books. So from various resources.
Nice. Is this a composition or what is this like?
Yes. This is a composition.
Got it now. Now I got it.
Got it? Okay.
This time I'm sure.
Okay. Anirban, you want to try?
No, I'm still calculating.
It's not easy. Yeah. Okay. Let's go with Vaibhav. And if he's wrong, then both of you get 0. If he's right, then Vaibhav, then Rucha will decide. 1 point or half point for Vaibhav. Let's go, Vaibhav.
Okay. So let's try, Vaibhav.
Okay. I'm going to go rook C3 doesn't make a difference, na? C3 or G3, I guess. Yeah, I'll go rook G3.
Okay,
so rook G3, pawn E3.
Yeah, queen C8.
And it's a stalemate. It's time to shake hands and it's a draw.
Okay, just one last try I will do.
That's the right expression, Vaibhav. Right expression.
No, I should have gone rook C3. Right?
No, he was so focused on stopping bishop H2 check, you know?
Yeah, Vaibhav.
I was thinking rook C3 all the way and then I was like, oh, that's the
how
point.
Does it,
I can't
how does
give...
it make a difference, Vaibhav? If you play queen
C3, no, it doesn't. Yeah, it doesn't. So, hurry up.
Both anti-intuitive. It's a different, like, you know, you have to think a little bit differently.
Out of the box.
Out of the box.
Okay, let's give one chance to Anirban and then we share the answer.
Right. Okay, Anirban, go for it. Kuch to aisa alag aapke, you know, the move is like yours, Anirban.
Yes, I think first move is queen G7.
Okay.
Okay, so bishop H2 check.
Ek move
I think I sense that it's not solved.
yeah. So then I take the bishop.
Okay.
Second move. G1. Let's make a bishop.
Okay. Let's see
what the hell is happening here. okay.
Do you not want to make a pawn just if you want to play around?
Oh man.
So this is your third move now. Whatever you play, and you can't mate in three.
Is it rook b3 or f3? I'm just asking.
No.
Okay.
Rucha, time for you to reveal the answer. And guys,
yes.
hold your seat. Yeah, it's going to be amazing.
Okay, so I think we did see some answers in the chat. So those who found it, congratulations. So the start of this answer is first move, rook h3.
Okay. I'm forced to push the pawn.
Yes, that is the only move for black. And here we play the brilliant move, rook h1. And now you see, we are again forcing black to capture this
only
rook.
Only move. This is pinned. Yeah.
Yes.
So take.
And you take it. And then queen takes h1. That's GG. That's GG.
Beautiful, right?
Wow.
Yes.
I was thinking of H1, but I just did not know how to get the rook. I was thinking if I get the queen, then it will die. What?
Yes, so it was difficult as well as easy, we can say, because we are not giving much options for black. But once we find the idea, then it seems like, okay, this was possible just to get the queen on this diagonal.
Is this from a game or is this like...
This is a composition.
Just 30 seconds, somebody is...
Okay, sure.
This is insane.
It was so nice, you know, and this is the thing that you guys have to think a little bit out of the box, Vaibhav. You can't keep thinking in the usual patterns like the game. So, Rucha, I'll put up the next position. You tell me which number and Anirban would join in and then he will think. But till then, Vaibhav can at least start and also the chat can think.
Okay, then let's go with one moment. Let me see.
Okay, let's see. Which one? Guys, let's did you like this position? It was amazing.
Game 8.
Oh, 8. Okay, let's see. I'm also very excited. Which one, Rucha? Oh, Rucha, this one is very interesting. Okay, let's go.
Is it something promoting to a knight?
Yeah.
Okay, white to play. And what is it? White to play and?
White to play and win.
White to play and win. But
okay,
no,
so the king
no
is attacking
moves,
the rook right now. So this is no limit of moves.
Yeah, okay.
No limit of moves. So this is white to play and win. And before we start solving this, we should know that in theory, rook versus knight is a draw in theory.
Okay.
But there are some exception positions also, if the knight is getting trapped in some way or knight is stuck in the corner.
So what Rucha is saying that in case you move the rook away somewhere and the knight takes this pawn, it will be a draw. So you have to be very tricky. Aapka rook mar raha hai yahan par. And your pawn is also hanging. Oh, joining in. Our third contestant here. Let's see if... No, not a huge gap right now in the score. So I think Viswa
yes,
can...
Yes. So this is our third position only.
Yeah. I think I have a guess, but again.
Okay, so let's see.
One second.
White.
Wait. No.
White to play and win, huh?
Huh?
White to play and win.
Yes, white to play and win.
Okay. Yeah, wait.
Hello.
Hello.
Mr. Biswa, how are you?
Biswa. Welcome to the stream.
Hi. Hello, Richa. Nice to meet you.
Yes, so welcome. And we are looking forward to your participation in this contest.
Okay. How much is the score?
Right now, Vaibhav is on 1. Anirban is on 0. This is the third position. So you can make it up. It's white to play here. I'll remove the arrows so that you can think. By the way, the last position was epic.
Epic. Beautiful.
Let me fix this properly to make this space for everyone. Guys, in the chat, please try to make yourself work, but at the same time, don't forget about your opponent's resources. The key to solving this entire positions today is to look at opponent's resources.
Yes. And these are not the standard puzzles that we have selected today. So also you have to be creative.
Absolutely.
Oh.
It's white to play and win.
White to play and win this position. And just so that Biswa, you know what's going on. If you save your rook and if the knight takes the pawn, then it's a draw. So you have to be very tricky and figure out. Also, I think all of you would have guessed by now why taking the knight is bad.
Yeah.
Yes, that should be the first question, yes? What happens if we take the knight?
So taking the knight is bad, and everyone in the chat also, please think why taking the knight is bad. You would have guessed it instantly. And then you need to now be creative and figure a way out to win. And this is so anti-intuitive.
Oof. I have one answer.
Actually, Anirban, if you solve today, like you play your games, you will get everything. Because in your game, just like how you sag stuff, that's the spirit you need today.
That is your style, yes? Of sacrificing pieces and playing original.
Yes, Rucha, if Anirban ever puts a piece near your f7 square, you can be sure that he will sack it there. It doesn't matter whether you survive, nothing.
Mm-hmm. And how can you describe the styles of Vaibhav and Biswa, their playing styles?
Vaibhav is...
Better player.
Vaibhav is very creative. He has no patterns or anything. He can play any way. Like he can play attacking chess. He can play any sort of... Biswa is more kind of systematic, positional player who likes, but he also likes to attack, but always like systematic. So they are all very different in
yeah, game. It's good to have different styles here.
Yeah.
King c6?
I also want to answer.
Okay, but Biswa, this is like this, yeah? For every answer you give, if your answer is wrong, you do not get another chance. Sorry?
Say that first. No, now I've given answer.
Tommy.
Yes, Sagar putting more pressure.
I also have an answer, so we can all go now.
Okay, let's go. Let's go.
Correct.
Let's start with Biswa first. What do you want to say?
King c6.
King c6 is Biswa's answer. Okay. What about Vaibhav?
Rook a8.
Rook a8. Okay. And Anirban?
Rook a8.
Rook a8.
Okay, so we have to rook a8 here.
Okay, Rucha, you can cross question them. You know, you can ask Biswa why his move, Vaibhav, Anirban, why they played the move. So
first of all, let's see, the other move, king c6, does not work here because it achieves a draw after king takes rook. And then you'd have to take the pawn and black takes the pawn and it will be king versus king in the end.
Oh, so, we're not going for a draw. I thought,
draw karna hai Biswa, to direct knight hi maar do na yahan pe draw.
Yes, you can take the pawn, you can take the knight. So, okay, so rook a8, now black has a few options. And first I'm going to play is king b7.
Yeah,
and
then should I answer?
Yeah.
Yes. Rook A7.
Rook A7. Amazing. Amazing. This
hot
is brilliant.
Move. Hot move. Nice.
Brilliant. Yes. So king takes A7.
Fourth now. Knight. You have to take takes knight. You lose the knight.
King takes knight. King A8.
Takes
and we reached a winning pawn in game. So king B8 and then
king
here.
King A6.
King A6. Exactly. And then the pawn promotes.
Yeah.
So let's give a point to both Vaibhav and Anirban because they both found rook A8.
Amazing. And just to finish off the line, if king A8, king
C8.
C.
C.
No,
yes,
take
king
the
knight.
If the knight takes, then king C8. And this is a Zook's Wong.
Ye dekho, koi square nahi hai king ke paas. And knight has only one square. It has to come and this.
Yes. And the king has to move and then we go to the same line as before. So king takes B6.
Whoa. Okay. So this puts Vaibhav on 2 points, Anirban on one. Very nice position. Yeah. It's so
great that they both found rook A8. Yeah. This was really pretty.
It was not easy. Not easy.
Yes.
Okay. Let's go to the next one. Rucha, which one?
Okay. Let me see.
Meanwhile, guys, I've put Rucha's Twitch channel in the description. If you guys would like to follow her regularly on Twitch, you can do so. She has many instructive streams there.
Thank you so much. Okay, let's go to game number 9.
Okay. Oh, this is a famous study. This is a famous study. Let's see, let's see. Not easy, guys, not easy. But today nothing is easy. White to play.
All right. So this one is a white to play and win.
Again, it's good to know here that theoretically rook bishop versus rook is a draw. So you can't just say, "Haan, theek hai, bishop bacha lo, rook bacha lo, aur fir rook ke saamne khelenge, we'll play against the rook." It would end in a draw. Trevor Nader has asked, Sagar bhai, in the last puzzle, rook d3 also works, right? Rook d3, ed3, queen c8, d7. No, Trevor, the problem is rook d3, e3 would be still played, not e takes d3 there. In the
yes, that's a good point.
This one is slightly tricky. Oh,
so
this
funny.
Vaibhav's laugh was as if he found it. Yeah, this answer.
Yeah,
I think so. You found it.
I think so.
Okay.
He's on fire today.
He's on fire. Yeah, I can agree.
Yes.
And these are all very cute positions. Dekho na, there are only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 pieces. Yet,
yes.
You can create so much magic with it.
You know, even with so few pieces on the board, there is so much happening.
Yes. Someone asked in the chat, where are the pawns moving? Black pawn is going here, white pawn is going this way. So, you know that you know what's happening.
Yes, that's a good thing to start with. Otherwise, you will spend a lot of time and it's the board is flipped sometimes.
Yeah. I think I found it, yeah.
And I must say that even chat is on fire.
Yes, yes, yes. Namit Bir Singh Walia found it. Also, if there's someone else, I think. Guys, don't give one move. Because one move means I cannot get the answer. You have to write the full variation. Okay, Vaibhav, you are done. Are you sure? No opponent defense is incoming. Just try to be very sure. Because here it's all about tricks, yeah? By the opponent.
Yes.
Experience has taught you, Sagar, that my being sure does not count.
But
I've been sure several times.
I asked, but you have surprised us twice now. So
I have a feeling.
So, in theory, as Sagar said, rook plus bishop versus rook is a draw. Even though there are practical chances, we should consider it as a draw on endgame.
Yeah. For example, if you play something like rook h1, I play fg6 check, you move the king. Maybe you can win it, but theoretically, it's a draw. So, you shouldn't go there. You have to find a forced win.
Yeah, I think I'm sure now.
Okay.
it's one of those tough end games, you know, rook plus bishop versus the rook.
Yeah.
Or rook plus knight versus the rook.
By the way, Anirban, Biswa, you have just 1 more minute left. So once your time is up, you need to give some answer if you want to score. Oh, I haven't enabled slow mode. Huh? Okay, sorry. Thanks, Ipsha, for letting me know.
Yes, yes. F takes g6 is a discovered check. So,
yes.
If it was black's move, black is capturing the pawn with a check on the king, and then also rook is under attack.
Okay, time up, guys. Time is up. Let's go with some answers that you have to, you know, say. Whom should we begin with? Let's start with Anirban this time.
Okay, let's go.
Anirban, any thoughts?
Bishop f6.
Bishop f6 is Anirban's move. Okay, what about Biswa?
I was thinking bishop g7.
Bishop g7, okay. And lastly, Vaibhav?
Rook g7.
Rook g7, okay.
Okay, so let's go from the beginning. So Anirban suggested bishop f6. So again, pawn takes pawn, and we are reaching rook plus bishop versus the rook. So even if you have rook g7 check, king goes to h8, rook takes g6, king h7. So this is the one we were talking about, rook plus. And of course, actually, it is much easier than we said, because rook and bishop are both under attack.
This is pinned here. In order to save yourself, you'll have to go here and then you lose material. I think this will be an instant draw.
Yes.
So bishop f6, Anirban doesn't work because of fg6. Biswa, your move, bg7.
So bishop g7. And a pawn takes pawn with a check. So now bishop takes rook, and then king takes rook. And this is also a draw because the bishop sacrifices for the pawn in the end.
Okay, now time for an Vaibhav.
Vaibhav's move. So he suggested a rook g7 check.
King takes h8.
Only move.
Rook h7. G7.
King g8.
And then g7.
Wow, amazing. We found this.
If the king does not take the rook, if king does not take the rook and just moves the rook away, then I give a check and pick up the rook, which is winning.
Yes, exactly. Oh, yeah. Incredible. Incredible. So takes and queens. This is the answer. Well done, Vaipo. And rook has no square to move. So we have skipper anyway.
Have some walk, see you. A lot of walk.
But Vaibhav, how did you find
it? It was so
this?
Funny.
So
the,
nice.
When I saw that I'm queening, I found it so funny. That so
over here, g7 doesn't work.
Yeah, so if we start with g7, the rook moves. And the problem is that the h8 bishop is blocking this check. And this is also again draw because the bishop can never get out from the corner. So we just need to remove this bishop in the beginning.
So the entire idea of this check and coming here is that so that this square is empty. There is no bishop. Oh,
we pick
nice.
This square. And then the rook goes anywhere. It doesn't matter. We have rook h8. And this is called a skewer.
Great. Okay. Great. Let's go to the next one. Rucha, which one should we go for?
Okay. So let's do one middle game now.
Okay.
Let's go to number second.
Oh, second one. Oh man, this is I don't know what to say, because today Vaibhav is on fire, so now I'm a little bit worried to say this is very tough. But white to play, guys, here. Rucha.
White to play and win. Yes.
Oh, white
so
to play and
have,
win.
We have a middle game position now. So white has a lot of attacking prospects with a bishop pair. Of course, both sides have bishop pairs, but white is attacking towards black's king side. So you can see both the bishops are targeted towards the king side. And that's why black is offering trade of queens. So that if you trade the queens, it's possible to dilute this attack a little bit. So how to keep the attack going, and why to play and win.
And Rucha, can you also give a small hint? Because it will help them to think in the right direction.
Okay, so in this case, when we say why to play and win, necessarily does not leads to checkmate, but even if we win any kind of material, so it can be queen, rook, or any minor piece, we can still say it's a winning advantage.
Okay.
So if you are able to get any material or trap any piece or find any tactics to win material, that can be a hint to look for.
Nice. Good job, guys, in the chat. A lot of people, Vikas, Nishad, Namit Bir, Mitesh. Brilliant. This one is quite tricky. And also, Rucha, if we just think about just taking on f5, e5 and bishop f5, that pawn up position is not so clear, yeah?
Yes, it's not enough. It's not enough. Okay, there is one way to go for it. So queen takes and takes the pawn. But there can be something better, so you can win something more. So I'm going to give another hint. So try to think if you can actually trap black's queen.
Whoa, trap black's queen here. Guys, this is the big hint. Big hint here. Music, yeah.
And that was from my side, so I had a raid on Twitch channel.
Oh.
Thanks for the raid.
This is from an actual game, I believe, right?
Yes. So imagine playing this in your own game. This is so nice.
Yeah, this happened in 1980,
mm-hmm,
between Philgut and La Garza. Oh, and let's put yourself in Philgut's shoes. Did he find it, Rucha?
Okay, yes. So if you think in that direction, it's possible to find.
41 years ago, someone found it. Oh, guys, you can do it. You have a couple of more minutes.
So try to keep the queens on the board, and we are trying to find, to trap black's queen in some way.
Not at all easy, actually. You have to consider all the squares that the black queen can go to, take away its squares. But then, you know, be very brutal with the defense for black.
Mm-hmm. Yes. So right now, black queen has only one square to move, right? So queen f6. Oh no, there is queen h5 also.
Yeah.
So queen f6 and queen h5.
h3 also.
Yes, you're right. Queen h3 also.
Big hint by Anirban there.
So queen f6, h5 and h3 are the possible squares for the queen to run.
Justice for queen h3. Okay. All those who are thinking of moves, like, you know, whatever move you're thinking, think about what your opponent will play after that and whether you can win. Don't just be lazy and say, okay, it's done, you know, I've found it.
Yes. So it also helps you in improving your calculation if you try to think more what happens after.
Yeah. Okay, guys, let's go. How about starting this time with Vaibhav? Vaibhav, would you like to give it a go?
Yeah, I haven't solved it, I think. But we queen f3.
Queen f3.
Okay. Queen f3.
And then queen f6.
Mm-hmm.
Knight g4. Queen e7.
E7, yes.
And it's not getting trapped.
He's not getting trapped, and also I don't think there's a very strong attack coming on the king. You can defend
it. I was thinking of taking on h6 after that, but yeah, maybe not. I don't know.
Possible. It's
with the bishop.
Possible,
taking on bishop, because taking with the knight is very... threatens me.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Oh,
what about Nirban?
I was thinking queen g2.
Okay. So queen g2. Still black has queen f6. Okay, black has two options. So queen f6 or queen h5. So what do you think about queen h5?
So then bishop e2.
Okay. Then queen goes back to f5.
वो स्क्वायर जो
okay,
पहले जा सकते हैं यू कैन रिपीट
देन
इमेजिन हैविंग अ रिपीटेशन हियर
g4
ओके सो क्वीन टेक्स h4
आ यू मीन ये इधर गया क्वीन h5 g4 दिस विल हैंग विश्वा व्हाट्स योर मूव इफ इट्स लाइक मेरे को अभी तक मिला नहीं है बट यू हैव टू से समथिंग
Queen h1.
What?
Queen h1.
Queen h1 is Biswa's move. Okay, what's your plan?
Okay, so now queen has two squares, h5 and f6. So let's try h5 first. Queen h5.
Queen h5, bishop e2 maybe.
Mm-hmm.
Or sorry, just g4.
G4 is actually trapping the queen.
Queen trapping.
So let's find another variation.
Queen f6.
So this is the problem variation. I know queen h1 will be the answer, but how to make this work is the problem.
Q, hold on.
This is beautiful.
Oh, hold on. If then bishop g5, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah, bishop g5, if it takes. Then we take and the queen has to go somewhere, but otherwise there is queen h7 mate.
Whoa.
Nice.
Rucha, is that right?
Seems like. I think she's stuck, but I think it's right, is it not?
Rucha, no. Rucha got shocked that you found it. Queen h1 and
see, somebody said queen f3, somebody said queen g2. Obviously, if they don't work, there is nothing else on that diagonal, so it has to be...
No, but it could also be queen e3,
queen
e2.
Yeah, queen e2 भी हो सकता था.
नहीं वो h4 hanging जो अनिर्बाण का है ना उधर से मेरे को clear हो गया.
Yeah, by the way, so move is queen h1, very powerful move. Queen f6 को bishop g5 and queen trap है, so you have to take the queen and then take and queen फिर से attack and mate यहाँ पर.
But what if he can't come anywhere. It's done. What a beautiful move.
Very nice, no?
Damn nice.
Fantastic move.
I'm at this stage of the game that there is like a definitive move.
Exactly.
Crazy.
I'll just wait for Rucha to return. Until then, I'll...
Dude, you have to see the second position.
Ha, Biswa, should I show you the second position?
These positions are insane, dude.
Yeah, yeah.
Jab tak wo Rucha comes back, I'll give you one position. So this one, we'll give it to Biswa, the point. But the second one, which was not found by anyone. And Biswa, if you can find it, it'll be epic.
Hi, okay. वैभव को नहीं मिला तो फिर बहुत कम चांस
व्हाइट टू प्ले
मस्ट पोजीशन
एंड मेट इन 3 मूव्स मतलब व्हाइट टू प्ले एंड मेट विन तो इजी है क्योंकि बहुत कुछ है बट 3 मूव में कर रहा है यू हैव टू डू इट इन 3 मूव्स
दीस आर दिस इज वेयर आई फाइंड लाइक सच थिंग्स आर सो फनी लाइक चेस ना ऐसे लगता है
दिस इज माय हंसी आती है कि यार मैं नाउ आई एम सीइंग इट इट्स सो फनी
Yeah, now when you see it, you feel like ये मतलब कैसे सोच सकते हैं? Actually, when you look at it at peace, na, maybe you can ingrain certain patterns कि next time कर सकते हैं. कैसे?
Actually, but you know what? How this becomes funny? I think like there are some times, जैसे इसके next वाले में भी, I found it so funny ना, जब ऐसा लगता है ना कि कुछ ऐसा move चल जाए कि opponent को खेलना तो पड़ेगा ही, और यार बेचारे की परेशानी देखो, like it becomes so funny कि देख यार क्या कटा है बेचारे का यार क्या कटा है.
You know, chess would have been a very different game if we can pass. You know, like so many positions would just not work. अगर कोई बोलेगा pass, हाँ, zugzwang would have gone out of the window.
So rook takes e4, and now
Rucha, you're back.
Yes.
And that is stalemate.
Rook takes e4 is stalemate.
Got it. So rook f3 basically.
One second, let me get you on the screen again.
Okay.
While you were gone, Rucha, we just gave the position to Biswa, that second one, which he
made in 3-1.
Yeah, made in 3-1.
Mm-hmm.
Hold on.
This is just beautiful.
Rook f3, it's forced that he has to take.
Yeah.
Now queen g8, and he has only two moves. Whatever he does, you just do queen b5 mate.
Yeah.
Is that the answer?
Sorry, can you say again, Biswa?
Basically, rook f3, pawn takes.
No, I'm not going to pawn takes. I'll play e3.
Pawn can go to e3.
You go to e3?
I'll play stalemate ke liye khelunga.
No problem. go to e3. Then... rook f1.
Concept rook f... concept acha hai.
No, rook f1. Hey. If it takes, I take. Oh man, it's a stalemate.
But f1 pe kyu khela?
Rook, because I want to give him a move.
Okay.
Rook f3, e3, rook.
You're on the right track.
While Biswa is thinking, Rucha, there's a question from Shikhar Pawa. Any advice on how to look for such forcing positions in a game?
Okay, so it's actually a good question. So especially when we are solving positions like this, it's a good idea to first look at the forcing moves. And if you're solving more tougher positions, one good advice is that you can look at 5 important things when you're trying to evaluate any position. So first can be material, so you can have a quick count of the material. Then second can be immediate threats, what is happening on the board right now, next move. Then third is position of the kings for both sides. Then is position of the pieces, if the pieces are active or not. And last can be pawn structure. So if you try to use these things, then you can get a good direction where you should think and how you should continue from there.
Nice. Okay, Biswa, I'm going to show you this answer because...
Rook f2, I think.
No. So the answer, because if you play rook f3, e3, rook f2, check, and then this is the third move. So you can't win. So the answer is very similar to what you thought, but rook h3, e3, and now rook h1.
He must take.
What
a beautiful position.
Yes, this was very cute.
is this a study or this actually happened?
No, it's a study.
This is a study.
Now, of course, it's a study. Of course.
But I had the same question. When I was like, yaar, ye koi game mein khel diya hoga.
I don't think in the game nobody will care to find this. Just win with queen and rook.
Yeah.
So, Rucha, next one, which one should we look at?
Okay, what happened with the queen h1?
Queen h1, Biswa got it right.
Okay, so we checked a queen f6, right? Queen f6, yes, and bishop e5.
Yes.
All right. Well done, Biswa. Well done. This was a really nice move, queen h1.
Damn nice.
Great move.
Okay, so next.
Which position should we take?
Okay, let's do game 6.
Game 6, okay. This one looks tricky. Hint, I guess you may have to give some hint, but let's see if, guys, Rucha, what to do here?
Okay, so this is why to play and win. And I will give you one hint that if this was black to play wins with the same trick.
Oh, so, acha. If it is white to play, there is a similar idea to win. And if it is black to play, also similar idea to win.
Yes, yes.
So it's a big hint.
Yes, so it's like a symmetric idea for both sides. Okay, so materially both sides have 2 pawns each. It's equal material. So we need to act immediately. We need to find something right away.
It's such a nice, it's so good. I mean, when you look at it carefully, it's so beautiful.
Yes. And also that it works with black to play. It's amazing, right?
Yeah, exactly. That's what makes this even more beautiful. That black to play also wins in the same way and white to play as well. Mm-hmm.
I see the similarity, so I know I'm on the track. But...
Okay. Okay.
Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Oh. Ah, okay, okay, okay.
Yeah, I think I found it.
Yeah.
Okay, okay. Anirban, last few seconds. Think. It's not so tough, Anirban. Just think of it this way. How will you coordinate your bishop and queen to launch kind of a mating attack against the black king?
Yes.
What a deviation, Sagar.
क्यों आपके माइंड में कुछ और था?
डेविएशन चल रहा
है. Hold on.
See, Biswa found the defense. Vaibhav is not even seeing. Vaibhav, ध्यान से देखो, आपको भी defense मिलेगा.
I have a feeling, I'm sure.
No, I have a feeling क्या? I'm sure, बोले फिर.
मतलब मेरे को तो श्योर ही लग रहा है ना अभी आप ढूंढोगे मेरे को पता है आई डोंट नो ऑल ऑफ
शिट देखो ना एवरी मूव लुक एट एवरी मूव एंड सी इफ ओपोनेंट हैज अ डिफेंस
You know, this composition was made in 1910, so long back.
And who was the composer?
It's S. Clapham, I don't know, but it was made in 1910, so long back.
111 years ago by S. Clapham. Wow. So, it's a study, yeah? It's not a game position.
No,
the value of the B6 pawn.
अच्छा B6 pawn का भी आपको value
है? I'm just saying है नहीं मैं ऐसे ही सोच रहा हूँ कि वहाँ क्यों रखा है like ऐसा
that's true that is how composers think
yeah.
when they are solving that what is the relevance of D2 pawn what is the relevance of B6 pawn
yes
okay let's go shall we let's begin with Biswa this time
okay let's go
bishop
H5
Okay.
Okay. So king takes the bishop.
But let's also ask the others first, shall we?
Yeah.
Okay. Vaibhav.
Same bishop h5.
Bishop h5. Okay. Anirban.
Oh, I did not find that.
Acha. Okay. Okay. But
I thought,
guess something. Guess anything.
Queen b2.
Oh, okay. You want to check here? Interesting. Okay, Rucha, shall we look at bishop h5 first?
Yes, so bishop h5, king takes h5.
Queen h7.
Queen h7, check. King g4.
Queen h3.
Queen, king f3.
Queen g2.
Yes, exactly. Queen g2, that's correct. And now in this case, we are winning the queen on a8 with a wonderful skewer in the end. Good job.
Beautiful.
Bishop h5 is right. We should give points to bishop h5.
Vaibhav, you also saw the full variation, right?
Yeah. Yes.
And also, if it was black to play, to kaise?
Bishop
h3.
Yes, so the exact symmetric idea we have. Bishop h3. Okay, we can't. Yeah, bishop h3, king takes h3, then queen h1 check, king g4, queen h5 check, king f5, and queen g6, winning the queen on c2. There we go.
Very nice.
But king versus king and queen is draw, no?
Huh? What?
That's a joke.
Please don't give me shock.
That's what Sagar taught us. King versus king and queen is draw. That's why I'm losing so many matches.
King versus king and queen. I just published a video teaching how to checkmate. Okay. Anyway, but Nirban's queen b2, although very logical because it threatens queen h8, I think can
king
be...
King g6?
Yeah, possible. Queen g6.
Maybe bishop f5? No, queen b6. He's going after b6 also at the same time.
And also f6.
Yes, so maybe queen
b6.
But is there any defense to queen h5?
Sorry, bishop h5, no?
Not here, in the previous variation.
No, but this
queen
just, h5. I think this move
queen c6, so
okay.
Queen h8, then king g6, bishop d3, king f7, and I think the king runs away.
But Anirban, not a bad move, yeah? Not a bad move. It was a decent try.
Mm-hmm.
Bishop h5, there is no way to escape this. Because even if you go here, check, and kahan jaoge? Here, if you go to f8, it's a mate in one. And if you go here,
queen f6.
Check
f6.
Here.
And bishop check.
Check here.
And you can take the queen also.
Yeah,
but what if the bishop comes to f5?
Bishop
in the
g6
second?
Is mate. Sorry. Bishop g6, king g8, queen f7, and queen
that's
f7.
Also.
Bishop f5 in the first move. Queen just takes, no? It's the same thing again.
Yeah, yeah. If the queen takes, but then the queen is freed. The black queen is freed.
Yeah, but
yes.
Like, then you're a piece up, no?
Ah, matlab yahan pe you're piece up. Because this is a threat still, and you still, when you take on h5, it's still the same concept, like...
Yes, nothing changed.
Okay.
And still winning the queen.
So
when
right.
the queen comes to g8...
When?
You still remain piece up, no?
Ah, okay, you mean here.
Ah, but is there mate then?
Okay, so after bishop h5, now here, okay.
But I don't think, maybe even just g4. I think it's winning. Totally.
Yeah, this is a big winning advantage. Or we can just move the bishop away anywhere. Even bishop f7 or just anywhere.
Yeah. What's the point of b6 pawn? People are asking. Why is the b6 pawn there?
You know, sometimes it's also true that in compositions, they add pieces to make it more interesting. So it's not always that everything is out there, but also we have a balance of material in this case with the pawn.
Is it because queen a6 would have been a defense to this? Maybe that's why.
Oh, yes.
To avoid queen a6 defense.
If this was not there, then queen a6 here could have defended. Very interesting. Yeah,
mm-hmm.
I guess so.
Yes.
Yeah, very nice. Okay, which one is the next one?
So, next one, let's go game 11.
Oh, this one, this is one of those positions when you send the database, I solved it and I was like, wow, let's see if any of them can solve it.
Okay, let's do this. So, this is a white to play and win. So, again, no limit of moves, it's just white to play and win.
So
in this case,
What, Vaibhav? You found it?
This is so funny.
You found it?
I don't know. I found something. I don't know if there's a defense.
Actually, Vaibhav has a very unique style of solving. Yeah, like people who solve, they are like, yes, I got it or something. Vaibhav just laughs.
अरे कितना फनी है लाइक ऐसे में फंस जाए आदमी तो इट्स हिलेरियस
एवरीवन सेइंग गिव अ पॉइंट टू वैभव फॉर आंसरिंग क्वीन ए6 बिकॉज़ ऑफ द बी6 पॉन नो पॉइंट You found it, Vaibhav.
But like, there's options after it.
Okay,
there's a very funny variation, but yeah.
Think. Also,
I think because it is so nice, maybe that's the beginning. That's what I'm thinking.
Anirban, think about sacrifices.
Matlab
aisa simple move mat socho. Queen B2 kya hai? Queen B2, in your game, you never play Queen B2. Here you are playing Queen B2. go for something very flamboyant here. Rucha, is this also a composition?
Yes. So this is also a combination, composition. And this was composed in 1917 by Kubel.
Wow, you've got all positions which are like more than 100 years old.
Yes.
But Kubel is a very famous composer and I think has composed some beautiful chess studies.
Mm-hmm.
Some people in the chat are very hopeful that, you know, you can just move the bishop away and then there's a mate and all.
I think
Black is actually threatening a mate in one. You should point out that queen g4 is a mate in one.
Yeah, this right if now. You do anything silly, then this will be checkmate.
Yes,
and also
yes,
there are checks like this in the air. So, dekho, bahut sare jaan, lot of people have said that, and I'm sure one of them is going to tell that move. But let's see.
आप बहुत हिंट दे देते हो यार सागर. क्या है ना वो हिंट से फर्स्ट मूव तो मिल जाता है बट उसके बाद का आगे देखना की पॉसिबिलिटी सो मेनी.
We really can't
afford to start with d4 for example.
Well, very nice. Yes, if you play d4 here, then queen g4 is a checkmate.
Queen g4, he's mate.
Very nice, very nice. Some people have found it very well done, guys. Also, a lot of people in the chat are mentioning a move here, but guys, I just want to point out that that is not the right move because you are not looking at defenses for your opponent. Okay,
I'm
last
almost
1 minute.
There.
Yes,
almost there. Come on, last 1 minute.
Yes, go for forcing moves. Otherwise, Black keeps giving check anyway.
You know, solving a study is a lot like being close to the answer, and then when you get it, it's like all the pieces of the jigsaw puzzle have fit in, and then the entire picture comes.
Yeah, eureka moment.
Yeah.
I don't think I have a song too.
But Vaibhav has got it, yes, this one?
No, I don't think so. I think there is a... I mean, I don't know. There are too many lines to consider after that. So.
I think I have something till you guys tell me that it's not.
Biswa has started his typical calculation tune. I think, Biswa, you get the tempo to calculate with this.
Yeah.
I think everybody in the chat got it, I think.
Really? Wow.
We are so close.
Okay, guys, last 30 seconds and then we go for
Okay, so just guess.
works.
Rucha, do you want to give any like earth shattering hint which they will then get?
No.
Oh, you've got it, Anirban. You've got it.
I think
we will start with Anirban. Okay,
I have it.
Oh, Biswa got
it. Everybody has something.
Okay, thought Anirban, you didn't get it fully. Okay, let's start with Anirban. What's your move?
Okay, yes.
Rook g2.
Okay.
Rook g2. Then queen check.
No, I mean.
So first of all, I want to see what happens if queen takes g2.
Then d4.
Then queen e4 check.
This is a mate. According to Anirban, it was a mate, but Anirban forgot that the queen can come in between.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Check, counter check, or fir pawn endgame haar jaoge. Because this is all lost.
Yes, yes.
Queen
e4 was crucial.
Lot of people said this, Rucha, in the chat as well, rook g2, but people did not notice first there is a check here as well. The second one is this is also very strong.
Yes.
Actually, checks ke baad it still works out, I think. But yeah, I did not see the move. My answer was also the same.
Okay, Biswa, okay, do you have a different move? Okay.
I have a different move.
Okay, go for it.
Rook f2. Mm-hmm.
All right. So now king has two options, g6 and e5.
Oh my god, so, g6. G6, then rook g2 and...
Yes,
and
that's correct. So king has to go to e5.
Rook f5, I think.
Wow!
Hold on. Oh. Rook f5, yeah.
Rook f5 is correct. Rook f5.
How did you find it, Biswa?
Wow.
I don't know how I found it, but I found
Wow. Wow. This is really amazing. Wait, now, so black has two options. King takes the rook. And here,
I think d4
is checkmate.
Then it's a, but is pawn takes?
D4 is checkmate.
If pawn takes, then d4, king has to go to d5 or
e4. Oh, e4 he can't go, right? Yeah.
Yeah. So yes, now this. So,
oh, and then the queen is lost. Nice.
Bishop a2. And this is amazing.
Also, in the chat, all those who don't know of Passant, please keep in mind it can be very useful.
Yes.
Nice. Damn it.
And then winning the queen. But well done, Biswa, in finding rook f5. Rook f5 was incredible. Incredible.
Yeah, I saw f5 dekha and then I was like, this is just done, but nice.
He was thinking so, he was so focused, you know, when we were all bantering and then he found the idea.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, like I was calculating after king e5, I was just calculating d4 immediately and it was not working.
Mm-hmm.
But then, so if you do d4, then the king escapes from c6 and nothing happens, basically.
Correct.
So you can't let the king go there. That's the
meaning.
So the right, the reason why you play rook f5 is mainly to open up this diagonal also, like ye wala, from here.
Yeah.
Beautiful. Okay, Rucha, which is the next one?
So next one, let's go for game 14.
Okay, game 14.
What position, man? This is mind-boggling.
Okay, so here, let's first talk that the pawns are going to the first rank. Queenie. So black is actually promoting. And this is white to play and draw.
White to play and draw. Because black's pawn is about to queen. And if you try to stop it from behind, the bishop will take it. So it's very difficult to stop the pawns. Oh, this is quite...
So, white to play and draw. Mm-hmm.
Okay, it's doable. Any hints, Rucha?
Okay, so first hint I want to give...
I don't think hints are needed.
Yeah, let's not do... Let's do one more without hints. Here. Yeah.
Either hint. Hint ke bina thoda tough hai.
Let's try without it, na? Like,
okay,
fir
okay, sure. Okay. We'll use thing for 2 minutes.
Matlab, giving us a position and telling that there is something in the position is hint enough, I guess.
So, yeah.
Well said.
But the thing is that you guys haven't been used to solving such studies. And
you give 2 minutes and then you give Pravachan for 3 minutes. Okay. then we have minus 1 minute to calculate. Okay.
Okay.
So, so you first say, then we'll start time. We first say.
Okay, I'm done.
Okay.
Oh, this is so interesting. Oh, this is so interesting. Yeah. Guys, in the chat, you are, you know, like last time you guys said Rook G2 and we got it and we got it. And then everyone was wrong because of that. Not everyone, but many of you. So here also, you are looking at one move which seems correct, but you have to be like very focused about the possibilities for your opponent.
Yes, yes. So once again, we need to find resources for opponent, for black.
That is the tough part.
As usual, I have an answer, which I do not know if it's right or wrong. But I now cannot think of a second one.
You know, Sagar, sometimes in such studies, it's more important to find the defense than the answer. Only then we find the answer.
Yeah. See, Vaibhav, you will find the offense and then you have to find the defense. And if you can't refute it, your answer is correct. But if you can refute it, you need to then go to another move. This is where you many times don't go to another option. So try to look at more moves.
Actually, the problem is the moment I see something, I think it works.
You can't unsee it.
No, because I think it works. I haven't found the proper defense. So I think it's working in my head. And then I see,
True.
I didn't
push
on my charger.
He has a very strong intuition.
Yeah.
About puzzles.
But also, I mean, in this, a lot has to do with intuition, but then a lot about willpower, right, Rucha? Because then if you don't work on the position, you don't look at more options, you don't look at the defense of the opponent, you can't find the answer.
Yes, actually, intuition is very good, but intuition plus calculation is what we are looking for.
Very well said. Very well said.
Oh, it's so complicated.
Pawn ko kaise, how do you stop it?
अरे क्या फालतू चीजें क्यों बोलते हो बीच में?
हाँ यार just like ऐसा जान जान पूछ के distract कर.
How do you stop the pawn?
The G7 square, you need to protect it right now. On this G7 is the most crucial point.
Helping you guys, I'm saying how do you stop the pawn? तो आप लोग बोल रहे हो नहीं वो important ही नहीं है.
मेरे को वाइवर, I know वाइवर's answer and I know the problem with वाइवर's answer also. It'll be hilarious when it's revealed.
But you don't know what is the right answer.
I don't know, but I think it's somewhere close to वाइवर's answer only. Let's see.
Biswa is like, वाइवर says, I got the answer. Biswa, इसका कैसा refute करूँ? Right answer छोड़ो.
Yeah. No, I know what Vaibhav is thinking. I'm thinking the same, but then there is a problem. Which is hard.
Oh, Vaibhav, surprise Biswa. Surprise Biswa by finding the right answer.
Arre, but mere ko ek hi pata hai na. Main change nahi kar
paa.
And I have a feeling if Biswa, like Biswa also same hi hai. Kyunki wo exact time pe bola na. The timing of him mentioning ki aap bakwas kar rahe ho. I know how irrelevant it seems.
Vaibhav knows the first move. And it's correct only, but then
there's a series of moves jo ki ifs and buts mein.
But I like how Anirban through all this talk is very focused. Anirban, any ideas?
I have one idea, but I think it's not tight enough. Just calculating.
Okay, let's shall we okay give 30 seconds more and then
yes then we can ask.
Rucha, you should give hints, yeah? Because they are not taking any hints from me. Whenever
okay.
I give hints,
so
they
shall
are
I
like,
give some hints?
Yes. You can first give. Of all. They won't tell you anything.
Okay, so first of all...
okay, if we are giving a hint, then we should be just say first move, right?
Yeah.
The first thoughts.
Achha,
okay, I will give very indirect
yeah,
hint.
Yeah, I think if all three of us are ready.
We have moves.
Okay.
Let's try
yeah.
them.
Okay,
then. Okay, let's go for moves then.
Let's start with Vaibhav. Vaibhav, you want to start?
Yeah, Rook C4.
Rook C4. Okay, Biswa?
C1.
Rook C1. Dekho, Vaibhav's answer was different. Rook C1. And Anirban?
Rook C1.
Rook C1. Okay. Very interesting. Rucha?
Okay, so shall we give hint or let's give the answer?
No, let's give the answer. Now they don't want hints. So
Rook. Okay.
I have a feeling Rook C1 is the answer. Because
everybody going with Rook C1. Also in the chat, I can see everybody.
Yeah, a lot of people wanted Rook C1.
And Sagar, you were giving them hints, but nobody listened to you.
No. They were like, no, we know everything. But Rook C4, Vaibhav, what is your idea? What is your plan?
So I thought that no matter where the king goes, I could not get out of checks. Okay, and if I keep on checking, there was some point like the king has to take. So I go rook b4. I mean, if he takes, then it's a stalemate.
No. This
is I thought it's a stalemate. Oh, God. Yeah.
So cannot work.
Okay, so rook c1. Now let's see what happens after rook c1. So rook c1 here, if we promote to a queen, of course it's a stalemate because now king can't move anywhere. But here black has a fantastic resource, and the black here promotes with a knight,
which everyone missed.
Yes, everybody missed.
Of course, how can there be a quirky puzzle round without a knight promotion?
Yes, so now king takes bishop and just knight goes to f4, and then black brings the king near, and then after that, the pawn will promote in the end. And you see that when the knight is supporting the pawn from back, you can never capture it. Because
if you take
then pawn moves. And
this is so weird. Like, promoting to a knight is like, how can you consider that bowler aake underarm bowling bhi kar sakta hai? What is this? Yeah. Suddenly.
Also very interesting is if you make a bishop here, if you make a rook, it's a stalemate. If you make a bishop, it's also not winning because now this is a wrong colored square on h1. So this is a draw. So only move that wins is a knight.
Okay. So
there is a different solution now.
Yes. So the solution is not rook c1. And we have similar solution. But we first give rook a6 check. And then we play rook a1. So the idea is that now when black promotes to a knight, the knight does not reach on time to support h3. So it takes, and you see knight c2, and knight doesn't reach, and the pawn is lost. And with single knight, it's a draw.
Beautiful. What a position. Amazing. Yeah. Great one. This one is by study by Needs, N-E-I-D-Z-E, and it was in 1960. Wow.
Yes, so everybody found rook c1, but I don't think this was seen that black takes and makes a knight. But after we find that, then rook a6 becomes obvious.
Yeah.
After the session, can you check with the computer if even computer is able to find this?
I think it will. It will. Like if you see, not after the session, we can check even.
Very
now.
Interesting. I've never seen analysis mein the engine telling me ki under promotion to a knight is the solution. Maybe I've never reached that position actually.
So here I'll just.
That's the only solution.
Under promotion is
this one. If you see, first move only, it's saying rook a6.
Wow.
Do you see it? So the computers have become very strong now to find these moves.
Yes. Okay, so
which one next, Rucha?
Next, game 16.
Rucha is ready with her next position. Which is it tougher than this one, Rucha, or easier?
Easier.
Okay. Yes. Okay. Let's go. This is going to be fun. Guys, white to, this is what?
White to play and draw. Yes.
And,
white play.
Rucha, some hint in terms, not the answer, but the, like you had said, rook bishop versus rook is a draw. So is there something they should know which they might not have an idea of here? Like some material balance, which is a theoretical draw here?
Okay, so for example, in this position, if you manage to get black's bishop, with keeping all your pieces on the board, it is a draw.
So two bishops versus queen is also not sometimes a draw, right? Two bishops versus queen, is it a? I don't think it's a theoretical draw.
Mm-hmm.
In that, the queen can sometimes win.
I'm not 100% sure about it. Two bishops versus the queen.
So you guys have to be a little more tricky. You keep find a way to hold.
And you know, sometimes when the positions is like this that you have to find rough, first of all, think which of the rules you want to apply. Like that can be a hint, you know, because there are different rules in which you can make a draw, like insufficient material, repetition, perpetual check, stalemate. So try to first see which one you can use, and then you can try to achieve that.
Initially, you said that two bishops versus a queen is unsure. And what was the confirmed draw that you mentioned once again?
If you have the pawn still left on c7 with the two bishops, then you will, it's a draw. So you need to win the G1 bishop for free.
Yeah.
Or something else.
Yeah, or something else. Now you guys know that it's all tricks, yeah, in such positions. This one also is a study. By...
Yes, this one is also a study. Let's see. It was... composed in 1980.
Okay. 1980 by Anufriev, second prize in Shakmati. A very famous magazine back then. And this got a second prize. Very nice composition. It's white to move. White to move. Also, just so that you guys know that just one bishop and pawn will not be sufficient to hold against a queen if you lose this bishop, because then, you know, the king will come out slowly on light.
Yes, that's a good point that you made.
So, Rucha, if someone wants to solve such studies, what would you recommend? Did you solve a lot of studies when you were young and, you know, you were...
Yes, I did solve a lot of studies. So, it's actually good to train and get good in calculations. But in general, tactics might be better if you want to solve every day, if you're just new at chess. So, tactics can go a long way. And studies sometimes, you know, to... appreciate the beauty, because studies can be very beautiful.
Because studies don't happen in your games regularly, but tactics happen, like similar fork, pin or double attack. But studies help to expand your horizons, your creativity. It makes you appreciate the beauty of chess.
Yes, exactly.
Okay, any leads in this one?
Anirban? Yes, I have.
I have.
Oh, I have one.
But I don't know, but one idea I have.
Very nice. Okay. And Vaibhav, so shall we try?
Yeah.
No. You just give it like
one more minute. Okay, one more minute. Rucha, meanwhile, can you get one of your favorite trophies from the backdrop, like which you have won? For people to see which one is your favorite.
Yeah, sure.
Okay. And then you can tell us the story behind it as well. Guys, this is a very huge trophy case that I see behind. It's of a very successful chess career.
Yes, you can see.
Oh, it's...
and...
Oh, my
God. You need another cabinet.
Yes. And I don't know which one to pick because they are all memorable.
Maybe like that one behind. One. Yeah, the one which is outside the showcase. It's very big.
Yes, it is my biggest trophy. It's after winning National B Women's Championship.
Nice. A lot of people have found it. Vivek Gupta, in the previous study, if black doesn't take on a1 and just moves the bishop away, then the rook will come to b2 and sack itself b1 and sack for the b2 pawn, and then that is a draw. Even if you have a bishop. Okay, let's go. Let's start with Anirban. Anirban, what's your move?
So, I'll move my dark square bishop to g3.
Okay. That's your move.
And the next move basically is light square bishop to f1.
So, first is bishop g3. And then whatever he does, you want to go bishop f1 here.
Yeah, so that I can go to a6.
But you can stop it, you know, in many ways, like queen.
So, what if we go after the pawn, like bishop b6?
Okay.
And then king, yes, king moves.
Doesn't work, but Biswa, what's your answer?
My answer is king takes on g1.
King takes g1, then queen takes d6.
Queen is bishop h3.
King takes pawn.
I just kept thinking the king will go to b7 for some reason.
Rather pawn blindness, pawn was undefended. Okay.
Yeah.
Vaibhav, anything else you have?
No, actually bishop g3 is what my answer was. But my idea was that after bishop g3, say for example bishop g6. Then I want to go king h3, king h2, with the idea now threat of bishop h3, which no matter what I will play, unless he plays bishop queen d2, which is worrisome.
Very nice. You found a defense also.
Yeah, that's what. Like I don't know now what to do because.
Yeah, that's actually a good move, you know, queen d2.
Yes, very nice. Yeah, he looked at the defense today. What he wasn't doing, he did it now, which is very cool. Looking at opponent's defenses, very correct. By the way, Rucha, can you reveal the answer?
Okay, so let's go for the answer. And this looks very unusual, but the first move is here, bishop h2. And now what we are trying to do here is that it looks unusual because we are offering trade of the bishops. So bishop takes, if bishop takes h2, then bishop h3 here. And now you see if queen takes h3, we are having a stalemate position here. So that's a draw. And let's see other choices for black. So after bishop h2, if black doesn't take, bishop goes anywhere else on this diagonal, doesn't matter, still bishop h3. And queen h3, and again, we have stalemate.
I forgot about stalemate while calculating.
Yeah, that's why, you know, Rucha had said that you need to think of which way you want to draw. Insufficient material, stalemate,
yes.
And so on.
So stalemate is very, very tricky in endgames.
Yeah, let's go for one more. I don't think we'll be able to complete all 20 positions, but we'll do a couple more, Rucha.
Yes.
And then so maybe we can do another part of this stream.
Okay, sure.
Yeah.
So next, it's one of my favorites. So let's go game number 17.
Your favorite. Nice.
Yes.
Yes, this is my also favorite. Guys, you will fall off your seats if you find this. Matlab, itna beautiful.
This is one of the favorites of all the collection today. So this is white to play and draw. Let's give some more time for this one.
Chalega. I'll be like crazy. So white to play and draw, Biswa, and this is Rucha's favorite position from today entire, and also mine. And I think anyone who sees this will fall in love with chess.
Yes, this is why we play chess. So first we need to understand what's happening and why we are playing for a draw, because we have same material but both kings are under some pressure. But the threat is that black king, if it moves, it gives a discovered check. That's the problem.
So if black move was here, he would just move his king to, I think, f3, and then it would be a mate here, or he would just take on h6 and it's a check. So black to move has a lot of threats, while white to move is looking for some checks, but whenever he gives a check, the king just moves away and gives a counter check.
Yes. I see that chat is trying all the possible moves with the queen.
It's not trivial. It's not trivial. Also, guys, let's just right now in the chat appreciate the effort from Rucha. She has collected all these positions, which are very beautiful. And, you know, she streams regularly on her Twitch. So, mods, if you can just spam the link. And everyone can just go and follow her. She's one of the best Indian streamers on Twitch right now. There's also Grandmaster Hari Krishna, who's very regular. Rucha, I think, is one of the most popular Indian streamers on Twitch. So please do follow her there for regular.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Murli Fani, for adding it here. Rucha, is there a way in which they should think here?
You know, Sagar, for this position, I'm also a bit puzzled how to give a hint. Because this is not easy to give hints. What do you think?
Yeah, my thinking is that you have to... I mean, stalemate is a recurring theme. Yeah, that could be a decent hint that in the end, there is some kind of stalemate on hand, so don't forget it.
So yeah, of all the possible drawing ideas, stalemate can be
yes
one of the ideas. But even in this case, even if we know it is, it's not easy to find how, exactly. Because we still have so many pieces.
The thing is, if you move your rook and you try to give a check with the bishop, then either he will take your bishop or he will move the king and give a counter check. And the king has no square after that, white king. Because bishop ka check, aisa aega, like it will come down this diagonal here. And the queen is controlling this diagonal and it's already a mate. So you have to be very careful there. So the rook seems almost impossible to move. Bishop seems impossible. And also the queen. Matlab queen se kaha check doge, that it stops king e3 ideas, because that is a check here then.
Yes. I think this is one of the best compositions I ever saw.
Who has composed this? Ooh.
Let's see.
It's by Gurge Needs.
Yes, yes. So it got first prize in a composition tournament.
This position cannot get the second prize. I mean, this one has to get the first prize.
Yeah, it is
prize.
First prize. First prize in composition.
But it's not so old.
Yes, 1985.
Mm-hmm. And the thing is, sometimes, you know, there are moments when someone checkmates you from a distance and you don't even realize that it's a checkmate, and you're like, what? Checkmate on the board? This position is like that. In the last position you see and you're like, what? Is the game over already?
Yeah. It happens sometimes, you know, even when you're playing online. Why can't I move this piece? Oh, it's game over already.
Yeah. But how is the chat doing? Yeah, nice. Some of them have found it. guys, think, don't give up. Any one of the good things, Rucha, that you see in all three of them is that they're not giving up. Like, you know, when I was young and sometimes someone would say, this is really tough, I would mentally give up. I would be like, nahin milega, I won't find it. But it's not them. It's for them. It's like, if it's tough, it's all the more fun to find it.
Yes, you know, it's true that you just mentioned, but not even as kids. Even now it happens that we become lazy sometimes, you know, like we see some move and we just want to play it out. That's it.
Guys, do you want to say what's going on in your head right now? Anyone like... Vaibhav, you are muted.
I'm saying I finally found something to work with, but like still to calculate it till the end. So maybe a couple of minutes and I think.
So right now, Vaibhav is leading in the scores.
Yes. Yes, I think we have had around 10 positions today. Prucha, how many? I'm not sure, but maybe chat has kept a count of it. Guys, if you can tell us how many positions have we already solved today? Because 8 I can already...
Let me check. So... Yes, this is the 10th one.
Oh, this is the 10th one. Nice.
Yes, this is the 10th one.
Nice. You know, generally, Rucha, Anirban, when he is playing a very intense game, he blinks a lot. Today he's blinking again, which means he's thinking very intense. Blink cam there.
Yes.
But the chat has been completely filled with chess moves. You know, like there's nothing else. Nothing else that they are talking about is just this move, that move, that move. That's how interesting chess is. That once you start thinking about it, thinking about the moves, you don't really worried about other things. Very nice. Very happy with how you guys are also working.
Yes. You know, Sagar, and also it feels different that we have been playing chess for years. It feels different to watch others and how they are doing.
Yes.
To be on the other side and how they are thinking.
Yeah. And I'm like, I sometimes put myself as a player in this position and player's shoes, and I think it would have been quite tough to find this, but
yes. But even
I have one attempt. Oh man.
Okay. Anirban.
Yes.
If you find this,
yes,
this will be amazing. You want to try?
Yes. Just 10 seconds. Last thing.
Okay. Anirban has got a pen and paper and all, and he's writing down.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Okay. Let's go.
Guys, do you want to listen to Anirban's answer?
No. I have something also.
Achha, you also have. Biswa is like, boli nahi raha hai kuch, and then when I say answer about to reveal, he says, I have something. Matlab...
I am calculating something. Hold on.
Vaibhav's face is very serious, so when he will get the answer, he will start smiling.
Okay, Sagar, how about we make this one like for 2 points?
2 points, okay. Okay.
Yes.
Agreed.
Yes.
If this was the last one, Rucha, we could make it also for 4 points. Then basically Anirban wins it if he gets it. Right. We winner takes it all. But yeah, we'll keep it two, and then later on we can carry forward.
Yes, yes. So competitive.
Oh, I hope this is it, man. This is insane.
You really got it, Anirban. Check the defense. Ko check ya.
But Anirban, were you really writing down the variations?
Yeah, yeah, I wrote down everything.
Wow. So we can see.
Okay. I don't want to show them also.
Okay, let's go. Yeah, like let's go.
Okay.
Let's start with Anirban. Yes.
Queen F4.
Okay.
So now the king has to go to third rank.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So F3 or E3. So let's go F3 first.
Then rook G3, check.
Bishop G3 is.
Oh man. Oh man.
I think you are looking for king E3 double check. With rook c3.
Yes. He saw king e3, I believe.
And then rook g3 then, is
the
double.
Yeah, my solution was like the king will come to e1, and then like my queen will e1, like after 2-3 moves it will roll, and then my queen will come to d2.
But only if king e3. I think Rucha, if he goes king e3, this works, right?
Yes, yes. So king e3, rook g3 is working.
Please, half point, please.
So this is his mate. But if
you see, even after in the last position is so nice. You see, rook and bishop both are under pin, and then you give checkmate on d2.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Can I go for like that f3 solution one more time? Like I'll just think.
Like here f3 ke baad kuch nahi hai Nirvan, because it's a check.
Okay.
And the king has nothing to do. You have to block with the rook and then just mate. So yeah, this doesn't.
So that was a good try.
Good try. Would you give some points there, Rucha?
Yeah, let's give half.
Thanks. I was worried ki ek se niklega hi nahi.
Okay, Biswa, any other answer you have?
Yeah.
What's your answer?
It's not working. But the idea is queen e5, that's the idea.
Queen e5, bishop e5?
Rook takes e5.
Rook at 6?
And I'm... And
I have one more answer.
Yeah, this is why I was checking rook takes e5 first. But it's somewhere there. The basic idea is we'll give up all our three pieces without him being able to move his king.
No. Mm-hmm. So you are trying for stalemate, to give the pieces. Yes.
Vaibhav, anything? Oh, you're muted. Vaibhav, you're muted.
I was thinking rook c5.
So rook c5 is a check. Then rook takes h6 check.
Yeah, and then rook goes back to h5. Yeah. Rook
so maybe takes. King g4 check. Or king f. Yeah, king f.
Yeah, both are.
I have one more try.
Okay, let's try.
Rook e5 I was trying, but it also doesn't work.
Rook e5, rook
h6. How about queen e3?
Okay, queen e3. So you're giving a free queen. I will accept it.
Then check g3 check.
You're under.
That's correct. That's exactly the solution. And you know, now the king moves and it's a stalemate no matter what black plays here. So it doesn't matter where the king goes. And the rook and bishop are both pinned. So it's a stalemate. Well done, Anirban.
Oh, nice.
Well done.
Oh, damn.
Well done. Let's give him 2 points for this one.
Crazy.
No.
Yes. Are 2.5 I'll get Biswa. I got two stalemates. Are what? I got two stalemates.
No. If you attempt twice, then I attempt twice, then Vaibhav attempts twice, then you get 2 points. No. We eliminated 5 possibilities. Okay, then you got it.
I found 2 stalemates.
But guys, look at this final position. No? Just appreciate the beauty
wow.
that
Yes, let's start from the beginning once again. So we give queen e3 check. So that is the first move. And black king can't go anywhere, so black has to accept it. And then rook g3 check. Have a double check by bishop and rook. And whenever there is a double check, you have to move the king. So king moves and it's a stalemate.
Rook cannot move, bishop cannot move, king cannot move, stalemate on the board with all the pieces.
I want to see an opponent's face when this happens to someone.
So that's what, you know, when we are trying for stalemate, even if you know it's stalemate, it's not easy to find this idea.
Crazy. Damn.
Amazing. Guys, do you want to end the day or do you want to do a last one before going?
Let's do one more.
One more?
Yeah.
Okay, let's do one more before ending. There were 10. Rucha, which one would you choose? And Rucha,
let's do one more for
2.1.
2.0. Okay, let's do another for 2 points and only one attempt.
Okay.
That's it.
I thought that was the rule anyway. No, that rule is introduced now. Just for Anirban.
Biswa got stalemated.
Stalemate. Nice. But yeah, okay, well done, Anirban.
Sagar, do you have any favorite of this list?
Oh man, there were so many.
Give something that Anirban can solve in 2 attempts. No.
Wait. Let me choose which one.
There is game 12 maybe? Or game 10?
Trash talking Anirban is too much fun.
How about going for... One second.
Okay, last is your pick from this.
My pick, yeah.
Yes.
Oh, yes. This... Some game... this one. Let's do game number 3.
Yeah, looks like Anirban can solve it or what?
No, but game 3 is a bit difficult because there is some theoretical knowledge also.
No, they will solve it. They'll solve it.
Okay, then go for it.
Let's try.
So, white to play and draw.
Yeah, white to play and win.
Oh.
Okay. So, this is white to play and win, yes.
Flashbin Gaming has put it well. It was like Black King said statues to all white pieces. Yeah, something like that.
So I think only thing we should mention here, it's not a hint, but that the pawn is same color. The bishop is same color as the promotion square for A2.
Hmm.
White to play and win.
Bahut hi mushkil hai because black ko simple hai, like he wants to come out here and just attack this and then push and exchange his pawn. Once the pawn is exchanged, it's a draw. So you have to think about something very, like now with all these positions you've solved, you know that it's never straightforward.
Yes, and also these small things, it's also important to notice them. So that bishop is same color as the pawn. So even in the end, if you are left with bishop and the pawn, it is still winning.
Mm-hmm.
So for 2 points, this can be the decider, you know?
For day one, yeah.
Yes.
This one is also a study. Wow. Is also a study by...
Wow, just wow.
You found it, Biswa.
I haven't found it. Huh. I haven't found it, but I'm just looking at the complexity. Like, I'm seeing some lines which, like, they're forced lines, but they're long forced lines. Like, very...
I think very... I found it.
But Vaibhav, you didn't laugh.
Matlab, I did not find it like till the last move. That's why.
Sagar, what happened is that he was leading the whole time and we just changed the rules. So it's not funny for him anymore. We made it for 2 points.
Yeah, it could be.
Well, I guess that was fair. That was a very, very nice one.
Yeah, Anirban ke liye to.
Welcome to Anirban's Chhapri Tactics.
What?
Mm-hmm.
This one is composed by Zakodiakin in 1932.
I think it works. Okay.
Sagar, have you ever tried like composing puzzles anytime?
I have tried, but it was not very great. I think I have a couple of compositions that I had done when I was solving, when I was really interested in solving. But they were not very difficult. I have to find them. But I think the entire process of composing is very, very interesting. In fact, recently on chessbase.com, they published an article of how a composition is formed. And I found that to be so fascinating. You have to, you know, get an idea, then you have to put some pieces, then you have to make sure there's only one way out. It's not easy.
Yes.
Do you have any, Rucha?
Very nice.
I think I did one of
I think
three, but trying to do like studies, but I also have to find them.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Vaibhav, you found it fully?
I think so.
Acha. Anirban?
Just seeing something, but no, I don't think I have found it.
Small hint here could be that you have to checkmate the Black King. Like,
yes, and if Black is able to exchange this pawn, then it can get tough.
Very interesting suggestions in the chat, Harinanda, Amit Dalankar. Guys, try to think about the defense for your opponent.
It's a win. It's the white to play and win. So I see some suggestions for chat. Some suggestions for drawing the chat.
No, it's win. Okay, Vaibhav, would you like to say?
Sure.
Okay.
Bolu.
Ha. Chalega, guys, should we go ahead?
Yes.
One minute.
Okay. Okay, last 30 seconds. Anirban.
Okay.
But through this entire thing that we have been doing, I think you would agree, everyone in the chat and also your Vaibhav, Anirban and Biswa, that it chess is very rich and very beautiful and very unexpected often. Even after years of doing it, there are positions which can really amaze you.
Yes, that's true. So millions of games played, but still we find something new every day.
Absolutely.
You can play for years and years and then suddenly there's a gambit. Which has a trap after the seventh move.
Okay, let's go. Vaibhav, what's your move?
King C7.
King C7, okay. Biswa?
And King C7.
King C7. And Nirban?
I also have King C7, but I have another answer.
Another bolo.
So you have to guess only one.
Aki.
A4.
Kaun sa bol raha hai? King C7 kya A4?
A4.
Theek hai, but you have to tell the variation. Also, Rucha, you take this forward now. It's very complicated, yeah, here, because it's the last. Yeah,
okay, so let's start with A4. So what happens if Black has few options? So let's say Black takes B takes A4.
Then King C7.
Okay, then pawn push, A3.
Only move, yeah? Otherwise, there's no other move.
Oh, God.
Okay, basically it's a draw, yeah, here. Yeah. You can't stop the pawn.
And if you took
Sagar has raha hai bol ke, I have a feeling there's a trick up his sleeve here.
Okay, so what happens after A3?
Anirban kaisa api solve kar raha hai think before
are udhar tak meko samjha ki wo ye wala jo a5 ka pawn hai isko rokna hai isliye a4 karna hai but uske aage tak nahi socha tha.
Okay, anyway, king c7, shall we just check Rucha, like how to, is this also winning or how is it?
Okay, so king c7, black has two options, so a4 and b4. So which one shall we go first?
Any b4 loses, right?
a4.
Okay, let's go b4.
Bishop a4.
b3.
Bishop takes.
Yeah, bishop takes, pawn takes. I think both should win, but there is a
actually,
faster
no,
way.
Pawn takes as in like pawn takes and then there is no movement.
It's a stalemate. Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
Bishop takes is necessary.
No, but can we do something else here?
Okay, so I think a black's might be best defense might be a4, right? Instead of b4.
Right. So okay, here this bishop b3 wins, right? Because you have the right pawn. And then sooner or later, by using Zugzwang, you will clean up this pawn and this pawn, and you will win. But the fastest way to win here is king c6.
Mm-hmm.
Because whatever he does,
and then bishop d5 is mate.
So a4 is much better.
Yeah, I didn't consider that. So maybe this is not the answer.
And then king a5. Consider. हाँ तो क्या विश्व आफ्टर दिस व्हाट डिड यू थिंक
a3 ओके सो किंग a5 एंड नेक्स्ट मूव b4 एंड ट्राई टू एक्सचेंज द पॉन
किंग
सो दिस डज नॉट विन सो द राइट मूव इज a4 एंड नाउ ही टेक्स.
Okay, now I understood after like watching the other sessions.
Okay, but we can't give him points.
Okay. Give one also.
Oh,
one. Give one.
Now I see the checkmate. No.
Because
now
we give him
chance
when he played a4. Now, of course, we see the same idea, right? It's the same idea. A3.
Yeah.
And bishop a4, a2. And then king c6 and a1. And then bishop b5 is mate.
Damn nice.
Okay, acceptable.
And also, b4 does not win because, it's the same mate.
b3 and bishop b7 or bishop b5 is winning.
And just for the sake of completeness, if king b6, then this
bishop
wins.
B5.
Because the right color pawn, you know, at the end.
And then the
king
will pick up the pawns in the end.
Beautiful.
Damn nice.
So a4 was very nice, isn't it? It's like we are trying to stop exchange of pawns, but we go a4 first move.
Yeah.
It's like anti-intuitive.
But I just want to inform you that in the game, we will not play it.
But
damn nice.
Anirban, Vaibhav, Biswa, did you enjoy solving these slightly
super,
you know different
super,
positions
super.
No, from usual?
Yeah,
so amazing. I think these puzzles are designed keeping in mind ki how do normal chess games happen, and then they're like, okay, so let's not make those things happen.
Right.
Like, right, let's write down all the moves that come to mind. Let's not use any of them.
Yeah.
But you know, it's...
Let's put a pawn blocking every of those moves.
Yes, but it's amazing that how you solved some of the most difficult puzzles today. It's really, really impressive.
Yeah, by the way, we have the winner of today is Vaibhav with 4 points and Anirban and Biswa with 3 each. So Vaibhav, congrats.
Anirban. Anirban is shameful second.
Shameful? What? I almost got the last one also. Okay.
Yeah, I missed 2-3 puzzles.
One puzzle
and
you
I got
missed.
3 points. Two puzzles I missed. Okay. Two I missed. And then you gave answer after five rounds, and you are tied with me. This is England versus England.
Sagar, can you tell me who got the only two-pointer in this 2 hour?
You are now trying to win by boundaries. I'm not going to support this. I'm New Zealand of this.
But really amazing solving today, and the positions were not easy. So to solve under 5 minutes is actually quite a feat.
Yeah. And Rucha, a big thank you to you for making this happen, because in a way, not only did you collect these, you sort of widened the horizons of people who are playing chess here, who are following this stream, because they could see that, oh, this is also possible in chess. So thank you so much for that.
Yes, yes. And maybe we can continue this series.
Sure.
Yes.
Super fun.
We'll look to finish these, because you have more 10 more positions in this. They are quite tough, but well, I think they also now have an idea of what is to be done, not just so yeah, we'll look forward to this. But thank you, Anirban, Biswa, Vaibhav, and thank Rucha. You. Thanks for this wonderful stream.
Bye, Sagar. Bye, Rucha. Bye,
Vaibhav. Thank you, Rucha.
Bye. Anirban, I'll see you later, Anirban.
Okay, I'll see you.
Thank you, Sagar, for the stream.
Yeah, and, it was amazing. Thanks, Rucha, once again. And
but really, I was quite impressed with the solving that happened today. Also, with the chat, it was so tough positions, but we had really, really great response and really great answers.
Yeah, I was also very happy with all three of them. They gave their best. They were trying so hard. And also, the chat, who was completely engrossed, they were completely engrossed, but I knew it when I saw the positions that they will be engrossed, because they were so nice. So once again, thanks, Rucha.
Yes.
And all the best with all your streamings that you are doing, and keep up the great work.
Yes, thank you so much, Sagar, for the stream, and we'll be in touch, and bye, everybody.
See you. Bye.
See you.
Guys, that was Rucha here. Just before I end the stream, I have a small request to all of you, that you can go and follow her on her Twitch, because she is working really hard on Twitch and she has some very interesting content. So I'll just pull this up. I think also it's very nice to see Indian streamers on Twitch as well. So just will put up her page so that all of you can go and follow her at some point. You can check out her streams, some very interesting ones. So this is the one over here, Rucha. And mods, if you can just spam the link, then she has some very interesting stuff over there. And you guys can follow her. Thank you, Joy. Thank you, Flashbin, I'll check out the email. And also, everyone, thanks a lot for being wonderful. Today also very interesting stream on Samai's channel. Samai's members versus Hikaru's subscribers will be very interesting to follow. I hope that it'll be interesting. Oops. Stream started. Oh, that's someone else. But okay, guys. Thank you all, and see you. Bye-bye.